What's up? It's Mandy Glam and I'm back with another perfume video. If you are new to my channel, then welcome, welcome, welcome. Thank you so much for stopping by to watch a video with me. If you are already a part of the Mandy Glam fam, then thank you so much for your support. I really do appreciate it. Here on my channel, mostly what I do is fragrance reviews. I love to smell good. I think fragrances are just like artwork to me. I think fragrances just complete me. Like, I never like to leave the house without spraying on some type of goodness. So if you are into fragrances yourself, you want to know more about the fragrances, maybe you're about to buy a fragrance and you don't really know what to buy, you want to learn more about notes and all those other good things, then this is the channel for you. So go ahead and click the subscribe button below. That way you'll become a part of the Mandy Glam fam. And also hit the notification bell. That way you'll be notified every time I upload a video. For all my glammies out there, I know your girl been MIA for a minute. I got a lot going on. As you can see, my background is way different. I'm in the process of making some changes in my beauty room. So basically, my beauty room looks a hot mess right now. I still wanted to come on and do a video for you guys. I miss y'all. Like, I miss doing videos. I can tell when I get rusty because I've literally started this video over like 5 or 6 times. I was like, no more. We're gonna do the video. We're gonna move. We're gonna keep going. I wanted to share a few of my more affordable fall fragrances. I've done fall fragrances that I'll be wearing this fall. I did 2 of those videos. Those are already up. I'll link them down below so you guys can go and watch those. But I wanted to do a video showing some more affordable fragrances that I really do like. One is actually new to my collection that I looked up on and found at Marshall's. I don't know how I got so lucky, but I was able to find it. It was one that I really, really, really wanted. So I'll be talking about that one here shortly. But yeah, so the first one I want to talk about, y'all know this is not a this fragrance is not a stranger to my channel. Like, I always talk about this fragrance. I like took a chance and bought this fragrance probably almost a year ago, and it was basically love at first sniff for me. Now, I know some of you have actually bought this fragrance solely off the recommendation of me, and thank you for that, because see, that means you trust me. You trust me, and I like that, okay? So, and some of you bought it and did not care for it whatsoever, and I'm sorry, girl. I'm sorry. I'm sorry you ain't like it, honey. Put it on Macari's or sell it, honey. Get your money back. I don't know. Hopefully you was able to take it back to the store, but we are talking about none other than, y'all know what it is. Go ahead. For the people, go ahead. Huh? Yes. Secret Obsession by Calvin Klein. Y'all know I've talked about this fragrance several times. I love it oh so much. I want to go over some notes with y'all for anyone that's new to my channel and you don't know what the hell I'm talking about. This is Secret Obsession by Calvin Klein, and I'm gonna tell you, I'm gonna go ahead and spray. I know what it smells like, but you know, sometimes you just need a little refresher, you know. So I'm gonna go ahead and spray it. Oh, I love it so much. Okay, so I'm gonna go over the notes for you guys. It is considered to be a fresh, spicy fragrance. I mean, straight from the nozzle, you get a very spicy note from this fragrance. There's nutmeg in this fragrance. There is woods in this fragrance. You guys, some of these notes are gonna kind of become a little bit repetitive, only because like I said, I go hard in the winter time, so you guys are gonna hear some of the same notes over and over again. So again, so back to this fragrance. This is again nutmeg, this is woods, this is plum, this is burnt amber. So there's also a note in here that I'm not very fond of, and it's tuberose. Now, it's not very prominent, because if it was, I wouldn't have bought it. I'm not a big fan of tuberose, but It's very well blended in this fragrance. So I won't go on too much longer talking about this fragrance. It's good though. It's good. Now you have to, it's a little bit on the mature side. I will be honest and tell you that. So if you're more of a younger person, you probably won't really enjoy this fragrance. If you're more of a mature individual, you like more of a heavy scent, you're not afraid to pull something off like this, then you'll enjoy this fragrance. Okay, so this is Secret Obsession by Calvin Klein. Right, another one that's a little bit more on the mature side. So if you don't really dig mature fragrances, you're probably not going to like this one. But this one is by Vince Camuto. This is the original Vince Camuto fragrance. I know there's a ton of Vince Camuto flankers that I really do like too. They kind of all have a similar note to them. But I believe this is the original of those fragrances. So I'm not even going to spray this one because I can just smell everything. This thing is given straight from the nozzle, so I don't even have to spray it. It's considered to be a woody floral fragrance. It has rum, patchouli, and vanilla. Now, what I get from this fragrance the most, right, even from the nozzle, like I said, I don't have to spray it. I'm getting rum, osmanthus, and patchouli. And then in the dry down, I get the vanilla. But again, this is going to be a, for those of you who are very like confident, you know, like a confident type of personality, you're not afraid to go in when it comes to fragrances. You love a loud fragrance. You love that beast mode fragrance. You love to, for people to smell you from around the corner. You know, that's going to be what this is going to give you. It is very good. I do, it's funny thing about this fragrance, I bought this fragrance in the dead heat of the summer, and I had the audacity to wear it because I had just bought it. This was probably 4 years ago. I had found it in Nordstrom Rack, and I wore it in the summertime, and I was just like, now this is before I became all bougie and decided I wanted to be a seasonal girl, which means I wear my fragrances depending on the season. I don't know when I started doing it. Honestly, I really don't know. But I'm glad I did, because look, you can wear your fragrances whenever you want to. If you want to wear this in the summer, spring, whatever, girl, knock yourself out. You can do that. But for me personally, this is only gonna be like, I can only wear this when literally it drops down to like 50s. It would have to be cool. I'm talking about heavy coat. I'm talking about I'm outside doing this number like this. I'm running to the car to blast the heat. Like, it has to be that cold for me to wear this fragrance, because it's a beast. Adrian Vettadini, okay? I am going to spray this one, and this is how you remove the top, and then you have the nozzle. Now, this one was talked about. Now, I bought this one on the recommendation of my girl, Valley Vaughn, the Perfume Don, some months back. She talked about this fragrance, and she really did enjoy it. This fragrance, I want to say I probably paid like $10 for this fragrance. It was not expensive at all. Okay, let me run down how much I paid for the other fragrances. So for this one, I paid at Marshall's $19.99. And then I want to say again, I bought this, the Vince Camuto, at Nordstrom Rack. I think I paid probably like $29 for it at the time. But I think now you can get it even cheaper than that, probably for like $20, $23. It's not expensive at all. And again, the Adrian Vettadini Midnight Blossom, I paid $9 for it. So this is really reasonable. Y'all, and I'm going to tell y'all straight up, no lie, this, for the price, for the what I pay for this, this is a really nice fragrance. Now, I'm going to be honest, I don't really care for any of her other fragrances. But this one I really do enjoy. Now, the notes in this fragrance include black leather, exotic red pepper, warm woods, and musk, okay? This fragrance, it, like I said, for the cost, it's really, really good. If you are into leather goods like jackets, purses, and stuff like that, you will really enjoy this fragrance because the black leather note in this fragrance really pops, and that's what you smell. Now, I don't get too much of the exotic red pepper, and if it's what I'm smelling, because I do smell something right when I get the first waft of black leather, I do get like a peppery smell, but I wouldn't, when I think of red pepper, I think of something really hot, really spicy, and kind of like irritate my nose or sinuses or whatever. It's not happening with this fragrance. This is a really, really good fragrance. I do smell the musk in this fragrance, but it's not loud and it's not like in your face, obnoxious type of musky smell. It's very well blended in the fragrance. So you guys, for $10, $10. This is Rub the Floor by Rihanna. Now, when this first hit the scene, I was not a fan. I'm not even gonna lie to y'all. I did not like this fragrance. This fragrance has literally grown on me, and I'll tell you, it is one of my favorite celebrity fragrances as of today. My second favorite celebrity fragrance is Cloud by Ariana Grande. I love that fragrance so much. Like, I will always keep that fragrance in my collection. I will always keep this one in my collection as well. This is, for it, you know, to be a celebrity fragrance, it is amazing. It is amazing. Yeah, okay. You can get it on FragranceNet. You can get it at all the discounts. If you're lucky, you can find it at the discount stores like Marshall's, TJ Maxx, and stuff like that. I've not seen it personally. I think I ordered this one online, and as you can see, I'm like almost done with the bottle. I will be repurchasing this fragrance. I don't have to spray it because I know what it smells like. Ugh, it's so good. It smells like I spent $100 on it, and that's the thing that I love. It's like, it smells expensive, you know? This is considered to be a fruity, sweet, vanilla fragrance with like coconut. It's also, it dries down to a powdery note. There's one note in this fragrance I was surprised to find out about, and it's that tuberose. I was like, excuse me, there's tuberose in this fragrance? Like, no way. I'm not a big fan of tuberose, but it's so well blended in the fragrance that, I mean, you don't even smell it. Like, you don't, you know, tuberose can stand out. Like, it could be like that first initial note that you get, floral note that you get in a fragrance. And for me, I love when fragrances have notes in it that I don't like. So, and then I end up loving the fragrance. I'm like, wow, that's a good fragrance then, you know, because the tuberose doesn't turn me off whatsoever. I'm not going to spend a lot of time on this fragrance because I know y'all know about the fragrance already. It is very popular amongst people, period. Not just YouTubers, but people. People love this fragrance. And I don't know how much I pay for this fragrance, but I didn't break my pocketbook. I didn't break the bank on this fragrance. I know this fragrance was very reasonable, and it smells wonderful. I wanted to include this next fragrance because I feel like it is a dupe for the Rêve de Fleur. In my opinion, it smells very similar to Rêve de Fleur. At first initial smell, when I first smelled it, I was like, oh my God, this is Rêve de Fleur all over again. I'm talking about Signorina Misteriosa by Salvatore Ferragamo. All right. And found this fragrance at my local TJ Maxx. Y'all know I love to shop there. I think I found this one for like $21.99 or something like that. I'm gonna go over the notes with you guys. I have to spray the Rêve de Fleur, but now this one, it still reminds me of Rêve de Fleur, but there is more of a sparkling note to it, more of a little pop, you know, whereas the Rebla Flora is more deep, it's deeper, has more depth to it. This one comes off as a little bit more youthful. This would be like a youthful version of the Rebla Flora, okay? So the notes in it include vanilla. There's a fruity component to this. It's sweet. There's blackberries in this. There is also tuberose. And there's also patchouli. So that's why I say this really, really, really reminds me. So even in the dry, it's the dry down. It's the dry down that is reminding me of the Rebla Flora. Look, they even have the same color scheme, like black and gold. Come on, black and gold. If you have both of these fragrances, smell them. Let me know what you think. Comment below. How similar? What do you think? Tell me if you think this smells like Rebla Flora. This is Illicit by Jimmy Choo. I really love this fragrance, you guys. I'm pretty sure you guys have heard of this fragrance before. I'm gonna give it a little spray just so I can oh my goodness, this is good. So on the price point, I want to say I know for a fact I probably spent like $24.99 on this one. No more than, because when I bought this one, I had a minimum of what I had a maximum of what I could spend. And so this made it into my purchase. So I didn't go over my budget. So I want to say this one's in the range of $21 to $25, okay? This is honey. This is citrus. It dries down to a very powdery smell. There's ginger in this. Sandalwood, it is considered to be a warm, spicy fragrance, so, and also a white floral. So if you're not into spicy fragrances, I don't know. Two different spicy though. It's not the same spicy as this, okay? This is a little bit softer as far as spice goes. But what stands out to me the most in this fragrance is going to be the notes of honey, citrus, ginger, and sandalwood. I love, this is like a nice fragrance, y'all. This is so good for everyday wear, date night, running errands, whatever. This is a really, really good fragrance. If you're into honey, you'll like this fragrance. Really, really good. And for the price point, girl, you cannot beat it. Jimmy Choo Illicit. So I ran into this. Ooh, this is Adam Levine. I have been wanting this fragrance for a minute. The first time I saw someone talk about this fragrance on YouTube was Sarah Mays. And she went on and on and on about how good this fragrance is. And I saw it and I'm glad that it was there. I picked it up quick. There was a few bottles. This is actually a tester bottle. You can see it says tester there. So I don't know, it was my first time ever seeing it at Marshall's, so you know I had to get it. $9.99. I love the bottle. This is like an old school microphone. It's really good. I've heard really, really good things about this fragrance, so y'all know I had to try it out for myself. Red, so we can get into the notes. This smells like, I'm gonna just tell y'all what this smells like. This smells straight up like Crown Royal. This is Crown Royal on ice, okay? That's a Crown Royal. And not that I'm a big fan of Crown Royal. I don't have nothing against Crown Royal, but this is good. This is boozy. So when I say Crown Royal, I'm like cognac, boozy, sweet, sexy, deep, loud, okay? The sillage is amazing. So I would give this on as a, so if I had to rate this in the sillage, I would give it an 8 out of 10. I immediately went to the car and sprayed it. Y'all know how I do when I find new fragrances. I go straight to the car, spray it. If I don't like it, I'm taking it back in the store. There's no need in me holding on to a fragrance I don't like. It just doesn't make sense to me. But there's saffron in this. There's benzoin, vanilla. This is a very boozy, good boozy fragrance. Like, this is good. For $9.99, y'all, I'm telling you, if you can get your hands on this, girl, you got a winner, okay? This is considered to be, in my opinion, a warm, spicy fragrance. So when it comes to spice, I think this one is a little bit more spicier, but they're similar in the spice. This has nutmeg in it. I don't know what the spice is in this fragrance, but it's spicy. It's considered to be a warm, spicy, balsamic, woody, vanilla, powdery fragrance. So it's good though. I mean, for what I pay for it, it is really, really good. I would totally recommend this fragrance. If you like the Secret Obsession, you will like the Adam Levine, okay? It is really good. So all of my cheap wintertime fragrances, or should I say chic, affordable, chic wintertime fragrances. I hate to use the word cheap, you know what I'm saying? Because nobody wants to smell cheap. You know, we don't want to smell cheap. You know, we want to save a little coin, but we don't want to smell cheap. We, you know, affordable. I'm going to say chic, affordable fragrances. So yeah, if you have any of these fragrances, comment below. Let me know what you think. Let us, the whole Mandy Glam community, know what you have and what you think about what you have. Because I'm telling you guys, people actually buy fragrances on the recommendations of you and me and everybody else that talk about fragrance reviews. So yeah, comment below and let us know, sis. Let us know. So again, thank you guys for watching. If you are new, you watch the whole video all the way through to the end, you might as well go ahead and hit the subscribe button, okay? I would greatly appreciate it for the growth of my channel. If you're already a Mandy Glam family member, thank you so much for stopping back by and watching a video with me. Y'all know I love y'all. I appreciate you so much. Love you. Love the support. So yeah, stay tuned. Make sure you turn on your notification bell too. If you haven't already, hit that bell. That way you'll be notified every time I upload a video. Thank you guys again. I will see you in the next video.